Hello and welcome 12th commerce students. Today in this business studies class I will try to end the chapter staffing from your business studies syllabus. Now in order to end or to complete this chapter staffing, I need to put emphasis on the last important topic from this chapter, and that is elements of a sound promotion policy. So as you can see, I have written in the board the elements of a sound promotion policy. This is our topic of discussion. Various points are there. I will write one by one all the points related to elements of a sound promotion policy. Promotion policy of any organization is normally determined by its personnel department. Every organization should have a properly devised promotion policy so that the employees can be promoted on a rational basis. A sound promotion policy should satisfy the following conditions that I will provide now one by one. First is rational basis. Rational basis. Now, what is the meaning of this rational basis? The policy should point out clearly what would be the basis of promotion, merit or seniority or both. It is rational that the policy should consider both the basis, seniority and merit. Both the basis are rational. So this is the first point. Second is equity and impartiality. Equity means equal. And impartiality means unbiasedness. The basis of promotion should be fair and impartial. There should not be any room for any kind of nepotism or favoritism, so that it is accepted by all the employees working in the organization. So it should be just and fair. Third point is harmonization. Harmonization. The basis of promotion should be implemented identically in all the departments of the organization. Different basis of different departments should never be accepted. Next is internal mobility. What does this mean? Internal mobility. Internal mobility of employees should be encouraged. Employees should be capable of doing, or they must be given better opportunities in other departments within the organization, so that they can be placed anywhere, and suitably they can be placed anywhere in the organization. Next is proper intimation for promotion, or we can write it proper promotion, proper reward. What is proper promotion? Whenever openings for promotions are expected, this should be notified through posters, notice boards, etc. in well advance. This will enable the interested employees to apply within the specified period. Next is training program. There must be a suitable training program. There must be a suitable training program, because the proper training program so developed will prepare the employees for promotion. Special retraining program are necessary for the existing employees to cope with the scientific and technological changes that may take place in the organization. Next is cooperation. Maximum cooperation, fullest cooperation from the employees are required. So promotion policy should be such that it can achieve the objectives. It should ensure the maximum cooperation from all the employees working in the organization. Next is job evaluation and analysis. You must keep in head all these points while writing the answer. Very, very important question this one. अच्छा, different stages of promotion are to be determined by means of this job evaluation and analysis. The policy should state the qualification, experience, aptitude required for each position, considering the job requirement in the organization. Next is responsibility or joint responsibility, you can say better. Joint responsibility. What does this mean? Joint responsibility. Now, the responsibility for selection of an employee for promotion should not be entrusted with a specific manager. It is justified that this task should be conferred on the committee basis. There should be specialized committee established for this purpose, for this promotion policy setting up purpose. So joint, it is the joint responsibility to fix up this promotion policy. Next is promotion on trial basis. Promotion on tenth point is promotion on trial basis. The policy of promotion on trial basis may be adopted to test whenever promotion is given to the suitable candidate or not. An employee will be promoted permanently with his efficiency and ability are provided. And next comes recommendation of superior. 11th point that I will write is recommendation. Recommendation of superior. What does this mean? Every promotion requires the recommendation of the departmental manager. Finally, the top manager takes the decision for promotion in consulting with all other personal manager of the personal departments. And last point, the 12th point is, I'm writing over here because of shortage of space. 12th point is a scope of review of promotion policy. So I can write this as review of the policy, review of promotion policy. This is the 12th point. It means that the promotion policy should be reviewed and updated from time to time. The lines of promotion should be clearly specified for each and every job. A sound performance appraisal system must be developed to assess the merit of each and every employee working in an organization. So you must cover up these points in order to write down the elements of a sound promotion policy. With this, the chapter of staffing comes to an end. In my next video of business studies, I will start up a new chapter from the business studies syllabus, that is directing. Till then, prepare these answers well, because these all are going to come in the exam, upcoming exam. So it is very important for you to prepare these answers. Always keep in mind that while preparing the answers, you need to keep this point under consideration. You have to write all these points when you will prepare for the answer. So wait for my new chapters video. Till then, goodbye.